is CLNS Radio, the home of Internet Sports Talk Radio.
Live from our studios somewhere in cyberspace, it's Beats and Eats, a happy hour for your mind. The virtual lounge is open, so come inside, grab a stool and your drink of choice. Can I get an amen? And now, here are your hosts, Ty Ray and Nick Gelso.
Thank you, bartender Scott Mitchell. Ty Ray, Nick Gelso with you on Beats and Eats, Labor Day edition. We debated whether or not to do a show tonight, but you know what? We could think of no better way to end the holiday weekend than by doing a show open in the lounge. We're talking music, movies, pop culture, you name it. It's Beats and Eats. If you want to get involved in the conversation, give us a call tonight at 347-215-7771, 347-215-7771, or join us on Facebook at Beats and Eats, and then on Twitter, we're at Beat, the letter N, and Eats. And what a show tonight. Very excited. I'm kind of a geek when it comes to 80s rock and roll, and we have got a rock and roll legend for you tonight. Mr. Eddie Money is going to be on Beats and Eats, and we all know the music of Mr. Eddie Money. You know this one, Nick?
I do. How could you not?
Love this song, Take Me Home Tonight. Really kind of a comeback song for Eddie in the 80s. He was away for a while, and this song went top 10 with Ronnie Spector. Eddie, of course, Nick, 30 million albums, 5 decades in rock and roll, and he's played with some of the greatest rock bands in history. Not only are we going to be talking rock music with Mr. Eddie Money, we'll also be talking with Movies Unlimited movie critic Irv Slifkin. We'll be talking about the hits of the summer and the bombs of the summer. And there have been some serious bombs this summer. Also some great films, Nick.
Yep.
Some great films this summer. We talked about The Butler at length last show. I love The Conjuring. We talked about that on previous shows too. So with that, let me bring you in. Like I said, Nick, kind of a geek. I'm a child of the 80s and was glued to my couch and literally would sit for hours. And I'm serious when I say this. I would sit for hours on my couch and wait for videos from Eddie Money. Those videos were Shaken and Think I'm in Love off his No Control LP. It was about 1982.
You know, I was listening today on Spotify, and you forget how many great songs this guy had. I mean, in my childhood, in my youth, he was all over the radio. You always, there was always an Eddie Money song on. He was very well known. Tonight I had a mini cookout with my family. I mentioned it to my cousin, who's my age. Holy shit, Eddie Money. So, yeah, I mean, and my little cousin knew who he was too. So, funny story, I want to go back. It was my brother's senior year song in high school. You know how you have a class song?
Oh yeah, very cool.
I'll always remember that. So yeah, just an icon, great, very successful artist, and happy to have him with us tonight.
Funny guy too. Very funny man. If you've seen him on things like King of Queens and that, let's face it, that Geico commercial is a hoot. And he's making fun of his probably iconic song in Two Tickets to Paradise. Everybody knows that song. And he's had other songs, but that one I think spans the generations. And just a funny guy. And I have the utmost respect for rock and roll royalty. Somebody that's been able to last as long as he has in the music business. Think about that, Nick. 5 decades in music. So many people have come and gone. I think the guy's in his 60s. Okay. And it's literally pedal to the metal with him. 150, 175 shows a year still.
That's incredible. There's got to be a passion for the music and what he does. And he still draws a crowd, so why not?
Yeah, he draws a crowd wherever he goes. And welcome back to Beats and Eats. Ty Ray, Nick Gelso, CLNS Radio with you on a Monday night, a Labor Day edition. The lounge is open, and with us on the line is rock and roll royalty. Mr. Eddie Money's been kind enough to join us on this Labor Day evening. He's just gotten off the road in Florida. Eddie, thanks for joining us tonight on Beats and Eats.
Hey, thank you so much. Great Labor Day weekend, everybody. It's nice to have 3 days off in a row, of course. We just did a sold-out show down there at the Hard Rock in Tampa. The place was a fit. There was like a Betty Boop cartoon. Everybody was Shaking with the Money Man. And before that, we did a show down in Hollywood, down at the Seminole Casino. We've been having a good time. You know, we played outside of Chicago. It's got a lot of great fans out there, and the show's been going great. It really having a lot of fun.
Eddie, man, it is pedal to the metal for you. 150, 175 shows, what, a year? I mean, you're just cranking them out.
Well, you know, I've got to tell you the truth. You know, the kids are happening right now. My kid, Desi's got a career that's really starting to take off. He's turned into quite the songwriter. And, you know, Jessica, she's getting herself back in gear again. So the kids are happening. And my other kid is into, like, dubstep. And I don't know, the kids, they're all in the garage doing God knows what. But they don't think they're going to be famous. You know, who the hell knows? They don't think they're going to be famous. She said, Dad, you made it. You know Bon Jovi. I said, guys, give me a break, will you? But the kids are doing good. Lori and I getting along good. We've got a lot of great fans out there. I'm supporting the Elizabeth Place of Pediatrics AIDS Foundation. These kids that are born HIV positive to no fault of their own. So I was out there selling shirts for the kids. And we got a new shirt out. One More Soldier Coming Home, a song about a kid that actually doesn't make it back from, say, Afghanistan. You can go to my website, anybody.com. And a lot of the proceeds are actually going to the Intrepid Fallen Hero Fund, which is a nonprofit charitable organization. They got two facilities, one in San Antonio, now they got a new facility actually in Maryland. So we do what we can for the troops and for the kids, you know that.
How do you keep your energy level up, man? You are everywhere all the time.
Well, you know, we just finished doing the Geico commercial, and they just used my song, We Should Be Sleeping. They did that for the Beauty Restaurant. So, you know, I mean, you know, plus I was on Guitar Heroes and Intrepid Auto, this and that. You know, we're getting a lot of airplay. And, you know, they always bring back the old Dick Clark specials and the Arsenio Hall stuff. And we've had a lot of fun. We've done a lot of TV. And Kevin James is a good buddy of mine. Of course, we were on the Kevin James Show. And then we were out there with Drew Carey. And, of course, I'm very good friends with Jay Leno. We get on that one. You know, it's great to get out on television, get out of the house, get back to New York. We got a place back in New York or Central Park South. My wife likes to go back there and jog in the park. I like to go back there and fight with all the cabbies, you know.
And that's where you're from. That's your roots, right? That's where you grew up.
Long
Island, right?
Kid. You know, I was a cop in New York City, and I grew up in New York City, but I'm more of a Brooklyn boy than a Manhattan boy. You know, I grew up in Brooklyn.
Let me ask you a question. I know you're a huge baseball fan. Huge baseball fan. You love the Dodgers. The last time I talked to you, we talked about the Dodgers, in fact. Does your love of the Dodgers come from being from Brooklyn?
Well, I want to tell you the truth. Now, what of my dad, when I was a kid, now, I'm a little older than you, but when I was a kid, like, you know, Jackie Robinson was playing baseball, Duke Snyder, Pee Wee Reese, Carl Ferrillo, Roy Campanella. I'm talking about the 1955 Dodgers that beat the New York Yankees. Well, my father was an usher at Ebbets Field. So I used to go to all the games. I grew up loving the Brooklyn Dodgers, and then when the Dodgers moved out to L.A., back in the early 70s, I moved down to Los Angeles, and, you know, I go to all the Dodger games right now. You know me. If you cut me, my blood is blue, baby. You know that.
And they've played great. It's funny. Everybody was asking for Mattingly's head, and then all of a sudden they go on the best run in history.
I'm happy for the guy. But, you know, I'm not that fickle, but in the beginning of the year, they were doing so terrible. I had better things to do. But, you know, I'm on the gravy train with everybody else. They're having a great year, you know. They beat the Padres. We're all happy, you know.
So how many games you get to a year, Eddie?
You know, I don't know what's going to happen. I'll tell you, the East Coast Division is a tough one back there. When you're talking about the Colorado Rockies and, the San Diego Padres, I mean, come on, what kind of division are you talking about? It's kind of like, you know, Little League. But you get back there, you talk about the Central Division, what the thing, you know, you got Detroit back there in the American League, and you got Philly back there, and you got Pittsburgh. There's some tough fights out there going on right now, you know?
Yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun. The Pirates are having an amazing year.
Yeah,
nobody
expected
that.
And I tell you, the Cardinals aren't just going to fall down and die, you know that?
No, they're always solid, start to finish, 162.
But
if you don't mind,
I'm very glad that the Dodgers are on the hunt because, you know, I've been out here. We feel really good about having a good year. Let's face the facts of life, you know. Everybody's very happy out here.
And if the Dodgers are having a good year, it's just good for baseball. Would you mind, Eddie, if I indulge you a little bit in going back to the past a little bit? I was talking to Nick, my co-host, about this earlier in the show. I used to literally sit on the couch in the MTV infancy and to watch and wait for Shaken because I was in love with Apollonia. What
yeah,
was that
like?
She
was a very hot young lady. I got to tell you the truth. When I first met her, she had a boyfriend that was a karate expert. He was older than me. He was really great. And he was out of his mind, jealous, crazy over the girl. I wasn't really into her that much because, you know, I had my girlfriend on at the set with me at the time. You know, women, especially in those days, I was in my 20s. You know, my old lady was on me like a fly on you know what. But, yeah, I'm a little bit sweeter. She was a sweetheart. You know, she got into those a lot of fun. You know, we did a lot of great videos. You know, I mean, we did that video, Think I'm in Love, when I played Dracula. Because the kids don't get to see that much because my first wife's in that one. Yeah, we made a lot of videos. Had a lot of fun. It was great. You know, I was like the heartthrob of MTV there for 5 or 6 years.
And then you did, of course, Take Me Home Tonight with Ronnie Spector, and you talk about class. What a video that was. It must have been just a thrill to work with her.
You know what? I'll tell you the truth. I called her up, and she had dropped out of the business. And she said, Eddie Money, oh, yeah, I know you from that Two Tickets Paradise. I go, Ronnie, there's a song that's a tribute to you, and it's got two choruses in it. She said, what? It's got Take Me Home Tonight, and there was one chorus. And it's got your original Phil Spector song, Be My Little Baby. It's the second part of the chorus. I said, I think it's going to be a smash. But, you know, when she did the song with me, when she's such a sweetheart, when she got into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, there I am watching it on TV. My heart was glowing for her. And she turns around and she thanks me. What a doll, huh?
Wow.
Wow.
And she had such an amazing career herself, and she went through her issues, too, and to unite with her and make just music magic. You still hear that song all the time. And Eddie, when you pen a song or a song comes out, can you kind of tell in your gut if it's going to have longevity?
You know, you kind of feel things like that every once in a while it came out. You know, like I never thought that Baby Hold On was going to be as big as Two Tickets to Paradise, but for some reason the record label picked Baby Hold On instead of Two Tickets. I would have picked Two Tickets instead of Baby Hold On. But, you know, it's crazy. Like, I never thought that Walk on Water was going to be as big as it was, you know. But, you know, you get lucky and you're in the right place at the right time. You do a good video. You got there. You play, you know, plus we were on the road with the Rolling Stones. We opened up The Who. We played with Fleetwood Mac. We played with The Cars. We played with Steve Miller. I mean, we've been out there playing with everybody. So every time I had a hit single out, whether it be a Take Me Home Tonight or a Walk on Water or a Shaken, I was always out there for a bunch of people, you know.
Do you ever take time out, Eddie, for yourself just to, like, look back at your career? I mean, I know you're a busy guy, so it's hard just to relax ever for yourself. But do you ever just sit back and relax and go, damn, what a career I've had, 5 decades. How incredible. The people that you've met.
Well, you know, it's a lot of fun. You know, when I think about the airport, when I think about LAX, or I think of, like, LaGuardia, this is like my office to me. You know, this is my office here. You know, the parking lot is like, you know, my front steps of my house. But, yeah, we do a lot of traveling. I mean, we're really a lot of people would die to be as big as I am in the States. I mean, I don't know if you could really sell me as a hostage in Europe. I did pretty good over there. But, you know, to go to, like, Columbus, Ohio, or to go to Fort Lauderdale, or go down there to, like, New Orleans, and people just coming out and checking out the show and dancing and Take Me Home Tonight and Think I'm in Love and I Want to Go Back. It's really a lot of fun, you know.
It must be really cool to see grandparents, parents, and their children singing your music. They're standing there on stage looking across this wave of humanity and everybody singing your songs.
You know, I got to turn around. I'm glad my wife's got me going back to church again a little bit because I got to thank God for all the things he's given to me. And I got to tell you, my music it's given a lot of joy to a lot of people out there. I mean, who wouldn't want Two Tickets to Paradise? Who doesn't think they're in love? Who doesn't want to take somebody home tonight?
Right.
It's all that, you know, we're all living the life of teenagers. What am I going to do?
So what's next for Eddie Money?
Well, I'm trying to get this Plinkett back on the ground. I wrote the song called I wrote the play called Two Tickets Paradise, and it was about me moving out to California with the guys in the band and quitting the police department and going to all the. It's really a great play, and I'm trying to get the thing back off the ground again. And of course, I got this song, One More Soldier, coming home. I'm trying to raise some money to help these veterans out with this Intrepid Fallen Hero Fund. And I'm just, you know, I tell them I got five kids up, doing anything to get out of the house. We're on the road all the time.
And Jessie doing great stuff again. She's singing with you on tour, right?
Well, you know what? When she comes out, she comes out. When she doesn't come out, she doesn't come out. I, you know, if I had a nickel for every time I wait for my daughter to come to jump in the car and go to the airport, I'd be a really rich man. It ain't happening.
And you said Dez is working too in music?
Dez, you know, they got a band together. My son's playing drums. My other kid's playing bass. They got a band together. They're practicing in the music room all the time. They're crazy. You know, they don't want to listen to me. My Lori says to me, why do you leave the kids alone? What are you, Joe Jackson? Quit picking on the kids.
Joe Jackson.
My wife says to me, leave the kids alone. What are you, Joe Jackson?
Well, I saw Jessie. I think she's very talented. I saw her one night. You guys were singing some stuff off of the, I think it's called the Wanna Go Back album. It's an oldies album from your days of Grapes of Wrath, right? Yeah, she was singing
She's getting ready to do this thing for Fuse, the Fuse TV network. They called her up. They wanted to host a couple of things. So she's getting ready to go back to New York. I think she's going back to New York and be working with the Fuse people. That'll be great. She'll have a lot of fun. She's very animated. You know, she comes up with all this funny stuff, you know. I don't know.
She's got a lot of charisma, that girl.
Yeah, she's a good girl, man. I call her Little Jessie Rehab.
Anyway, Eddie, I'll tell you what, we'll let you go. You've been very generous on this Labor Day with your time, and thanks for sharing the stories. And, man, continued success. Always a pleasure every time I get to speak with you. Best of luck, bud.
Well, I just wanted to tell you, you know, my wife was actually talking about divorcing me and moving to Las Vegas. I said, "What? Now what's going on?" She says, I'm a good-looking woman. I said, Lori, everybody knows you're a gorgeous woman. She said to me, an escort service. I said, what? She said, an escort service would give me $10,000 a night just to keep a gentleman company. I said, Lori. I said, you know what? I'm going to follow you to Las Vegas. She said, why? I said, I want to see how you're going to live on $20,000 a year.
Oh, man.
Hey, I was only kidding. Give me a break. Come on.
Yeah, funny, very funny stuff, man. No,
I mean,
very funny stuff.
My wife's not around, so it's boys night out. You know how I am, guys. Come on. Let me.
Oh, yeah. Very,
hey, listen,
very...
have a great show. Have a great Thanksgiving weekend, and I'll talk to you soon.
All right. Take care, Ed.
Thanks, Eddie.
All right.
Good night. That's legendary rocker Eddie Money on Beats and Eats. Who knew we did stand-up?
I was just going to say, we don't need a comedian tonight.
Wow.
Eddie was great.
Was that
great.
Something? He could do the show by himself. I don't
he
even
can. Think... He can, and he's a legend, and listening to you interview him was great, man. I mean, I just sat back and listened. I mean, Eddie effing Money.
On Beats and Eats, on CLNS Radio, rock and roll royalty. The guy has played Nick with everybody, and as you can tell, and just in my voice, we talked before I started the show, I wasn't in the greatest of spirits. But talking to Eddie Money, rock and roll royalty, I've followed this guy forever. He's had some ups. He's had some downs. I think it says a lot that a guy is still doing 150, 175 shows a year, Nick, in his 60s.
No, no question about it. I mean, he still knows how to rock. And, dude, I mean, opened for the Stones, played with Fleetwood Mac, and then the list of songs that he wrote that were – smash hits. I mean,
well, he started listing some I completely forgotten about.
Yeah,
Baby Hold On and
Wanna Go Back
and
that's my favorite one.
Yeah, I know you said that earlier in the show that you were really fond of that song. And
yeah.
I'm just a huge fan of his stuff. And yes, can it be a little corporate? But he rocked, man. I dare anybody dare anybody to call him a pop star. Go back to some of his early stuff in the 80s and in the late 70s. I love the No Control album. It is a complete masterpiece. And Nick, he nearly died himself. He almost overdosed. I don't know if
I know that.
And if you take a listen to his No Control album, it's basically a biography about going through that experience. And he went through rehab in the early 2000s as well. So he's had his fights.
Yeah, resilient guy, and he's still doing it. Sold out, where did he say, down in Tampa Bay at the Hard Rock? I mean,
The virtual lounge is now closed. For Beats and Eats, I'm your bartender, Scott Mitchell. Until next week, stay cool.
Very funny call.